There are many things we do every day without even thinking. We get up, take a shower, use the restroom, eat, exercise. But how do people do this in a tiny confined space? And also in a zero gravity environment? Well, astronauts have to do this stuff every single day. From sleeping to getting ill on board, to brushing their teeth and using the restroom, how do they do it? Thankfully, through live videos, astronauts have showed us. So let's check out the everyday life of someone in space. When you're in the International Space Station, almost every minute is planned out. That's because it's incredibly tough on the human body and mind to be up there. Also, it costs around $35 a minute for an astronaut to be in space. That's almost $50,000 a day, so things need to be accurate. But surprisingly, astronauts don't have a set wake-up time. However, they do need to be up by around 10 a.m. That's because every day there's a morning conference with ground control. If you're wondering what time zone they use in space, that'd be London time, or more specifically Greenwich Mean Time, which is where all time is measured from. So if you're ever wondering what time it is in the ISS, then simply look to London time. The reason why they use London time is because it's hard to tell the difference between day and night on the ISS. They also want to make sure that astronauts from different countries don't work and sleep at different times. On the ISS, the sun rises and sets many times in 24 hours. So once they're up an atom, how do they shower? Remember, in zero gravity, water would simply spray everywhere, so how do they do it? For this reason, there's no running water on the ISS. If there was, then water droplets could get into the electrics. This could ruin the $1 trillion ISS. That's why water is transported to the ISS in small bags with straws. To wash their hair, they simply push this onto their head. You could also squeeze this onto a cloth and use a wet cloth. Or you can use the Skylab shower. This is a shower head which you need to press directly onto the skin. It also immediately sucks in any used water afterwards to make sure it doesn't fly around the ISS. If you want to brush your teeth, you simply squirt the water onto the brush like toothpaste. Talking of water, what about using the restroom? How do toilets look on the ISS? Well, they're kind of similar to an airplane toilet. The only difference is that astronauts' toilets don't have any water. They're cleaned only with negative pressure. There's handles so astronauts can hold themselves in place. Or if they prefer, they can strap themselves in with a seatbelt. You would not want any mess floating away while you're trying to relieve yourself. Number twos are sucked into plastic bags. They are then let out of the ISS and they soon burn up in the Earth's atmosphere. Kind of like a shooting star, only more dirty. The weird thing is what happens to pee. There's a system on board which purifies pee into water. The American astronauts actually drink this, but the Russian cosmonauts famously refuse to do this and only drink normal water. What would you guys do if you were on board the ISS? I think I'd side with the Russians on that one. So, moving on to lunchtime, how do astronauts chow down? You've heard of space food, which is said to be very bad. But technology has improved, and now astronauts can eat normal meals. This food is normally freeze-dried or canned. Every day, crew members get 3 square meals, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and also a few snacks during the day. They can warm up the food, and using the rehydration station, they can also moisten any food. However, they can't be too slow when eating, otherwise their food could fly away. They have to avoid crumbs, as they could float away and damage the electronics. Astronauts say that the food on board is often pretty soggy. The dishes are made on Earth, and they're made with much more flavoring than normal food. That's because being in zero gravity means more blood will flow to your head. This swells up your mucous membranes and means you don't have much taste. That's why things taste different on airplanes. Only when you're in space, this is even more extreme. You may think that astronauts live a sedentary life when in space. After all, they just sit there floating all day, right? Well, no, in fact, astronauts need to work out more than ever. Astronauts need to exercise for at least 2 hours per day. That's because they lose muscle very quickly. That's because zero gravity means they're weightless. Of course, this means they have no strain and never need to pick anything up. They have very complex weightlifting systems, which rely on pressure, and they also have stationary exercise bikes. When they're back on Earth, they have to do lots of exercise as well. And they also have to strengthen their bones because your bones get much weaker when in space. Before we go on, be sure to check out my Patreon to help me out and see exclusive content. But what do astronauts actually do in the day? Well, their work consists of research and experiments. This is, of course, different for every astronaut. After they've collected their data from the day's experiments, they have another conference after dinner. They then have a few hours of leisure time. During this time, they can watch movies and also play board games. And there's even internet on the ISS, meaning they can browse the web. Nowadays, they can even video call their families or do a news interview live. Some prefer to simply look out the window at the amazing view of space. But after a long day of being in the stars, how do you go to sleep? Well, because there's no gravity in space, they need to strap themselves in. Every astronaut has some privacy in their own individual cabin. They then get comfy in their sleeping bag, which is attached to the wall. The weird thing is, because there's no gravity, the mattress simply floats above them. That's why sometimes they strap the mattress to themselves too, so they don't feel too weird. But what happens when an astronaut gets ill in space? Of course, before they go up to space, they have vigorous health tests. They don't want anything too serious happening on board the ISS. After all, there's no hospitals in space. Also, because being in space is so expensive, you don't want anyone getting ill, unable to do work. There's a problem though. In space, your immune system gets weaker. Inside the ISS, there is a small pharmacy, but many astronauts get what's known as the astronaut disease. This is during the first few days of being in space. Your organs are adjusting to 0G, and this often gives people extreme nausea for the first few days in space. You can also get space fever as your body temperature increases. Astronauts' body temperatures are usually 38 degrees. This means they pretty much have round-the-clock fever all the time they're in space. So, that's what astronauts do in space. But are there some things that they never do? Well, one perk of being in space is that you never have to do any laundry. Science has not devised a way for astronauts to clean their clothing while in space. So when their clothing wears out, they simply toss it into space and it burns up. But now it's time to make your voice heard. Now that you have this information, comment below whether you would want to be an astronaut or not. If you want some more amazing videos, then check out my second channel. But as always, thank you for watching. There are some more videos on screen right now. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe to Top 10s.